guys, you know what time it is. Time for my June weigh-in. I stepped on the scale and this is what it said. Okay guys, 179. Did you hear that? Did my weight start with an 80, 180, what? No, 179. That is a loss of 3.3 pounds from the last weigh-in. And if we're gonna be honest, my first initial thought was like, wow, 3.3, like, that pales in comparison to the 8-point-something that I lost last month. But then I realized I dropped into the next 10s, okay? That is a milestone right there. And I feel like a winner, and I feel so happy and proud of myself. I've had so many non-scale victories this month. First of all, my weightlifting is improving. I can definitely see the physical changes in my body. Secondly, I'm just really getting a handle around eating keto. I know that may seem remedial, but like sometimes it's hard to stay on track and sometimes you feel like you're forcing yourself, but then sometimes it's easy and you're in the zone and you don't have to spend as much mental energy worrying about what you're gonna eat and it just feels natural to you. And right now, I'm in that spot and that is worth so much more than a number on the scale. And that's what lets you know that the number on the scale is gonna keep changing, okay? You keep doing you, you keep putting in the everyday effort and the number on the scale has got to change. Like there is no other option, it has to do it. So I'm just so grateful that I'm back in that place where keto feels easy, making the healthy choices for my body feels easy, fasting feels easy, like I alternate day fasted. The entire month, like I've really, really settled into my routine. I would say that honestly, I have a handle on 6 out of the 7 days of the week. And to me, I'm really, really proud about that. The fact that I can go 6 out of the 7 days just without even thinking, being completely on plan, that's huge for me. The one day I have issue with is Sundays, okay? You know what it's like, it's the weekend, you wanna kind of feel like you're going a little crazy or going off plan or having a treat, having something extra. And so I really, really struggle on Sundays with not overeating and not overindulging for no other reason than that it's the weekend. Good news, it's all keto. I haven't even thought about going off keto this month, and that is another victory. But Sundays, I will say, that's when I'm a little more lenient. I go with the Quest bars. I have some ice cream. I do the things that I wouldn't normally do. And so my goal for June is just to get Sundays under control. You guys, like, I have every other day of the month figured out. There's only 4 days this whole month that I have to think about. And so I am really committed to giving my fullest effort to making myself proud on Sundays. And just think about that, you guys. I did so well every other day of May except Sundays. So think about how much more weight I could have lost or how much further along I could be if I stayed on track for those 4 days. That just goes to show 4 days matter. Like, you can't go off plan every weekend. You can't overeat even a few days, or it has an impact on your weight. At least it does for me. So I just want to encourage you, stay consistent every day. Look, 6 out of 7 ain't bad, but come talk to me after 7 out of 7. You know, come talk to me after a whole month of being on plan for real, even on Sundays, and you ain't gonna be able to tell me nothing. I tell you that. Okay guys, weighing 179, I am a mere 14 pounds away from my first goal of 165. I say first goal because I know once I get to 165, I'm not gonna wanna stop there or anything like that. If you remember, my lowest weight ever was like 155. So I definitely know that there's still plenty of room to go, but 165 is my first real goal after my big regain. Like, I never thought I would be in the 170s again. Like, that's just how easy it is to slide right back and how easy it is to become so hopeless about your ability to ever be able to lose and re-lose weight. Just know you can do it. All it takes is discipline and consistency and you can do it. You know how I know? Because I'm doing it. Like, I'm just so proud of myself. And I know that you have the tools to be proud of yourself too if you just stay consistent. Okay, but seeing as I've been feeling myself this past month, I was like, let me go ahead and try on my like gold bikinis. You guys, these are bathing suits that I've had since 2017. They have never seen the light of day. I only put them on for like progress pictures, but I was just like, let me see what I'm actually looking like. And like, it's not that bad. I got some room to go, but like, it's not that bad. And I can definitely see the difference and feel the difference from what they used to look and feel like. So I'm just proud of myself for having the nerve to put those on, for having the nerve to show you guys. want you to know it's never too late. It's never too late to make today day one, okay? And to go hundreds of days in a row. Like, there is just no reason you can't be successful. Just know that it is a decision that you make and you are in control and you have the power. I feel back to that pride that I had, back to that determination that I had to do what's best and to not just half-ass it and to not just be like, oh, well, I'm doing good enough. Like, now's the time to step on the gas. Don't let up because you see progress. That's the time to step on it and challenge yourself and continuously get better. And that's what I'm proud to say that I am doing. How did you guys do for the month of May? Let me know. My goals for the month of June are mainly just to stick with my weightlifting and to drink water, 64 ounces of water a day. I know you're like, Autumn, that's the regular amount of water that everyone's supposed to drink every day, but like, I don't be drinking that much water. And so I know that it is good for me, and I really think it's been helping my weight loss lately. So my goal is at least 64 ounces. The more, the better. Let me know what goals you have for June and any successes that you had in the month of May. I can't wait to hear all about them. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like it, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel, Watch Autumn Keto. I make meal preps on Mondays, What I Eat Wednesdays, and on Fridays I release any sort of video. Could be a keto crate unboxing, could be a monthly weigh-in, could be a date night with my husband. Anything on Fridays, it's a freestyle Friday. Thanks, and I'll see you next month.